Hibernation. Nearly every endkeeper have to deal with this time of the year when the ants need a break of their busy life. In this video I will talk about European species, Middle European and Mediterranean species. But if you're watching this video, for example from the US, watch it. You can compare the climate from the northern US with Middle Europe and the southern US with the Mediterranean climate. Okay, let's start with the ant species, which have actually to deal with a real winter, with freezing temperatures and snow. These ants have managed to survive months of freezing temperatures and a time without any nutrition. What do these ants do to survive temperatures below the freezing point? Well, they start preparing for hibernation by emptying their intestine and their social stomach. They get as much water out of their body as possible. Due to this process, their hemolymph, which is the insect's blood, gets thicker and this prevents the hemolymph from freezing. Due to this thick blood, the ants can stand temperatures down to minus 10 degrees Celsius or less without freezing. We have to divide the ants in two groups. The first group are ants like most carpenter ants. They have an endogenous rhythm. This means the ants have an inner clock. They know when summer or winter is, independently from their environment. So, how do we know when these ants are ready for hibernation? There are some behaviors which show us their status. The ants become less active in the outworld, they've closed the nest entrance, they've stopped eating proteins, and the probably best indicator is when your ants stop raising the small larvae. Eggs and pupae will probably die in the winter, but the larvae have the ability to survive the winter by reducing their water in their body. So, if your carpenter ants have larvae which haven't grown for some weeks, your ants are probably ready for hibernation. The second group are exogenous ants. Their rhythm is based on external influences, like temperature, light or nutrition. This means you have to decide when these ants have to start their hibernation. So, if you want to prepare them for hibernation, you have to slowly lower the temperatures and stop feeding them proteins. Because, like in nature, the insects become rare in autumn. When you recognize your ants' eggs and pupae become less, you know your ants are preparing for hibernation. An exception is the formica species. These ants hibernate without brood. The whole process of preparing your ants for hibernation can take up to 4 weeks. Now we've learned the difference between exogenous and endogenous species. But how do we send them in hibernation? When your ants have prepared for hibernation, you make it cold, really cold. You can put them into the fridge. Plus 4 to 7 degrees Celsius are ideal for hibernation. If you don't have the ability to put your ants in the fridge, you can put them into a thermal box and put them, for example, into the garage or outside. Just make sure they're well isolated and protected from water. Isolating materials like crumpled newspapers, bubble wrap or foam materials protect your ants of extreme temperature fluctuations. How long should hibernation take? Well, this is a good question. Usually I would say 4 to 6 months, but it is also depending from where your queen is. Malassia's nightshade colony is already in hibernation and I will stop it in March or April. This is the coldest time here in South Germany where I live. Okay, let's have a talk about the Mediterranean species. Their hibernation is not really a hibernation. It's more a phase of low temperatures and lack of nutrition. Due to these two facts, there's not really a reason to get out of the nest. In the most Mediterranean region, it's the absolute exception that temperatures drop below the freezing point. So these ants don't have to fight with the bitter temperatures. They more take a break. Like I've mentioned before, it's not really worth getting out of the nest. How do we put these Mediterranean ants in hibernation? That's pretty easy. You just need temperatures below 18 degrees Celsius. Recommended are 10 to 15, but I've made an experience with the master colony. As soon as the temperatures drops below 18 degrees, the ants are totally inactive and form something like a big ball in the nest. All in all, it's pretty easy with these ants, because they don't have to deal with the frost. Just sink the temperatures and the ants are in hibernation. But don't change it from one day to the other day from 30 to 15 degrees, make it slow, like in nature. So, how long do we have to leave these ants in their break mode? Well, this is like always depending on the original home, but normally less than 3 months. There are big temperature differences between North Italy, Tunisia or South Spain. I always send my Mediterranean ants from December to February in hibernation. All these ants are from South Spain and yeah, it's still pretty warm over there. If your ants are originally from Northern Africa, they might not even need this break. Find out where your ants are originally from and check the climate data. I hope I could provide you guys with some helpful information. Don't be scared by hibernation, all in all you just sink the temperatures. Change the temperature slowly and your ants can deal with that. Don't forget, we're talking about ants. These animals have survived ice-cold winters in Alaska or Finland. Only make sure your ants have always access to water and they can deal with everything. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching and see you soon.